comes the, here comes the, here comes the.
Y'all don't really want it like that.
Yeah. Here comes the.
So I keep big bills up in my heart, all look dirty like blood. So ain't got no twist in my head, but I'm still dreadful. And I got plenty of bread, so I go to bed full. I'm in it to win it, to win it, I'm all in. I might call you my cousin, young blood, but we ain't kin. You think of jumping, man, you best think again. The dirty, I'm the type of man that might go broke for revenge. Had some not so nice friends, kick the door off the hinge. Take the door off your bins, pop up my four of your friends, man. This is very cynical, nano subliminal. I'm physical, financial, and mental to be a general. Hey, the mama claims she want a soldier. Not the type be in the tank, but in that rover. Man, please, I'm in the zone like AIDS full blown. I'm killing it like a blind man reading. I'm feeling it like, oh, yeah. Here comes the, oh, here comes the, oh, here comes the. Y'all don't really want it like that.
Good morning, Bridgeford High School. Today is Friday, September 8, 2017. This is your WBHS News, and I'm Vitria Foster. Homecoming 2017 Journey to Atlantis will take place on Saturday, October 7th from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. in the cafeteria. Ticket prices are $25 for a couple and $15 for a single. They are now on sale in Ms. Canner's room. Bringing a guest from another school? Pick up a form in Ms. Canner's room and fill it out. They need to be turned in by September 29th.
And I'm Haley McFarland. Garrett Strong wristbands are still on sale for $2 apiece in Mr. Davenport's room. Jostens will be at Bridgeport High School to take class ring and graduation orders on Thursday, September 14th at 7:45 a.m. in the cafeteria.
Hi, my name is Nate Stewart, and today I had the privilege of interviewing the new principal, Mr. Daly, a little bit about himself and this upcoming school year. Mr. Daly, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Okay. Well, come here from teaching, teaching background. I taught for 12 years at the Jefferson County JVS. While I was there, I taught science. A lot of years were spent teaching anatomy and physiology and environmental science. A couple years I did teach physics and physical science as well. Also come from a background of coaching. 15 years I coached football. So those gave me quite a bit of experience that allowed me to step into this role.
Would you mind telling me a little bit about your personal background?
Okay. I grew up in Mingo Junction, Ohio, which is just south of Steubenville, Ohio. Lived in those areas for most of my life until recently. I'm the youngest of four siblings. I have two older brothers and an older sister. Married to my wife for 7 years now, and we have a daughter that is just turned three in July, and we also have a dog. Adrian is her name, and she is named after Adrian from Rocky, which is one of my favorite movies, and she just turned, I believe, 10 years old.
So this is your first year as principal, and how do you feel right now being put in a situation that you have a lot of leadership in?
I feel pretty comfortable, actually. I feel as if this is a natural fit for me. Everything I've experienced so far at Bridgeport and dealing with the school board, the staff, parents, students, it's been a very welcoming atmosphere. And I think a lot of my background, when I worked at the school where I taught at, I had a lot of leadership roles there. And being involved in coaching, there's a lot of leadership roles with that. So it is a new experience, but the things that I have to do are not completely unfamiliar to me.
So this is your first year as principal, and you already seem to have a lot on your plate. Like, you want to get started this new, like, leadership and club program. Would you mind telling me a little bit about that?
Sure. Our leadership program is going to use a book by John Maxwell. called the 21 Indispensable Laws of Leaders. The aim of that is to get students to realize that at some point in their life they're going to become they're going to get confronted with a situation where they have to be a leader. And it may be on a small scale, it may be on a large scale, it may be just within their own family as a leader, it may be leading a large group of people, but I want them to be prepared for those situations when they arise. And I think the book lays out 21 skills that a leader needs, and it's going to let the students know that these things are within them, and it's going to help them to be able to bring those out when those opportunities to be a leader come forth. The club meetings, our goal is to expand the clubs that already exist, make them more active, and to also present students with more opportunities to join clubs that they may be interested in that will benefit them as students, but it will also benefit the school too.
One last question for you, Mr. Daly. What does it mean to be a Bulldog in your opinion?
Okay, that's a good question, and I think the best way to answer this is to kind of give an analogy. I actually had a Bulldog as a pet at one time, not too long ago, about 4 or 5 years ago. And I can say that having a Bulldog as a pet, they are very loyal pets. They are very tenacious pets, meaning that they'll continue to do something over and over again until they get done what they want to do. A good example is that he would carry logs, railroad ties, pull them from one side of the yard to the other, and you tell him to stop, but he would keep going. He was very stubborn about it, and just to be a tenacious individual, to work until the job is done, but also to be a very loyal person to those that are close to you. I think those are two great characteristics of Bulldogs, and I think those are great characteristics that I've seen from our students so far, loyalty and tenacity.
Thank you very much, Mr. Daly.
Okay, thank you.
I'm Lauren here with your sports. The Lady Dogs volleyball team won on Tuesday against Payton City. They fell to the River Pilots on Thursday night. Come support the volleyball girls Saturday against Ferry at home. JV starts at 1. The golf team had a match at Crispin last night and will play again September 11th at Belmont Hills. Good luck, guys. The football team plays Weirton Madonna tonight at home. The theme is a blackout. Come out and support the dogs.
Your lunch for today will be chicken fajita, green beans, carrots, mixed fruit, and a chocolate oatmeal bar. Have a great weekend, Bridgeport.
Loves horses and a boyfriend too.